إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة، فصلوات الله وسلامه على رسول الله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على خير خلقك وأفضل رسلك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وآل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين وزوجاته أمهات المؤمنين، وعلى الصحابة الغر الميامين أبو بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وجميع أصحاب نبيك أجمعين، وعلى التابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، أيها الإخوة الكرام، يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في سورة الإسراء: سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله لنريه من آياتنا إنه هو السميع البصير. الإسراء، سورة الإسراء أو سورة بني إسرائيل، the other name started with سبحان الذي أسرى، meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, glory to him, the one who made the Isra, Asra bi'abdihi. Al-Isra is the journey at night. We call it in Arabic Isra. Subhana الذي أسرى بعبده. عبده is the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. سبحان الله، الله سبحانه وتعالى، الذي أسرى بعبده، who took his servant the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم من المسجد الحرام when he was sleeping in the Kaaba, near the Kaaba in Mecca, and he took him as he was in his bed, warm. And Jibreel alayhi salam came and told him that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants me to take you to Bayt al-Maqdis, ila al-Masjid al-Aqsa. Jibreel alayhi salam is taking the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam using the animal called al-Buraq. It's like a horse or smaller with wings. And they went to Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa at that night. And that's what they call it Al-Isra, Rihlat Al-Isra. Subhana الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam went to Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. He found all the Prophets and Messengers by their souls in the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought them. Obviously, all the previous Prophets and Messengers in their graves, wherever they are in terms of their bodies. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought them to the Masjid Al-Aqsa, and they prayed jama'ah with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As he said in Sahih Muslim, in the authentic hadith, that he led the prayer with all other prophets and messengers, and he named them. Then after that, there is another rihla called Al-Mi'raj. Al-Mi'raj, which is from Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa to the seventh heaven, إلى سدرة المنتهى, as Allah mentioned في سورة النجم, عندها جنة المأوى. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, with this great journey of Al-Isra and Mi'raj that strengthened his heart and gave him great support by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this journey came after Aam al-Huzn, Aam al-Huzn, the year of sadness, when his wife Khadija radiallahu anha, she passed away, and she was the first lady to accept Islam and the first person before Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. She is the first person to hear about the revelation about Jibreel alayhi salam meeting with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi Ghar Hira, in the cave of Hira in Mecca. And also his uncle Abu Talib, who was not Muslim, and he died even non-Muslim, but he was politically and financially supporting the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as his nephew, who grew in his house, an orphan, with his other children. So he was the carer and sponsor and guardian of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he supported Islam and the da'wah of Islam politically in Mecca, where the hardship and difficulties and torturing all Muslims who are accepting Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gift the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam al-Isra and al-Mi'raj as a great journey for him after the year of sadness. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam met different prophets and messengers in the heavens. And he met Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him about the importance of 50 prayers a day. 50. Directly, Allah revealed the obligatory prayers directly to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Hadithat al-Mi'raj, without any mediation of Jibreel alayhi salam, but directly. And in the sixth heaven, Musa alayhi salam was there. And when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam met him and told him about the 50 prayers. And as you know, Musa alayhi salam has the second biggest nation, Bani Israel. And he has great experience. He told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that your nation will not afford and able to do 50 prayers a day with all the deficiencies that the human has and have. And it's going to be a very great struggle for them. Go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask him for reduction, to reduce the 50 prayers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reduced it to 45. Just imagine that. And Musa alayhi salam said, where are you going? He said, I am going with 45 prayers a day. He said, your nation will not afford it, will not be able to do it. They will struggle. And he went back, forth and back, until the 5 prayers. And Musa alayhi salam said, your ummah still will struggle with the 5 prayers. Go to your Lord and ask him for reduction. And he said, I am so shy and embarrassed to go to my Lord and ask him for reduction. And this is how the 5 prayers in our daily life has the reward of 50 prayers. Every prayer you pray, multiply by 10. Subhanallah. And this is the Isra and Mi'raj journey, Where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went down again to Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa and then back with Al-Buraq animal to Mecca again, and he found his bed still warm. These miracles of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are indeed great. People didn't believe that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did this journey when he recited the ayah and told people of Mecca. But Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he said, I believe what is actually happened with you, and I believe in this journey of Isra and Mi'raj word by word, because we believed in you, in the revelation, and in the Quran, and in the Tawheed, and the oneness of Allah, and the Iman. So how we will not believe in this? This is why Abu Bakr, one of the reasons that his name Abu Bakr As-Siddiq, the trustworthy. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, when he died, before he died, the moments before he died, he said, among the words that he said, As-salah, as-salah, wa ma malakat aymanukum. As-salah, as-salah, wa ma malakat aymanukum. And he recommended us to take care of our prayers. Al-Masjid al-Aqsa alladhi barakna hawla. Allah said in the ayah. Al-Masjid al-Aqsa that Allah gave a blessing for it. And surrounding it. So the surrounding area, the land is blessed, people are blessed. Of course, people who are faithful and truthful and honest. Because Allah blessed Mecca and Allah blessed Medina, Allah blessed Baytul Maqdis. Allah blessed all the masajid. But all those people of masajid and these areas, they need to be with iman and honesty and sincerity first. Because there's no point to refer to our race or origin or location if we are not honest in the first place. But also the plants and fruits and food are blessed, even animals. And those people who know these areas closely, they will know the land, how rich it is. Even people eat things that grow naturally in the mountains around Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. The leadership of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with other prophets is a great significance for us, because we came to complement other religions, not to clash with them. We came to complement, to clarify, to give them support by bringing them to the original messages that they already received by their prophets and messengers, which is the message of Iman and message of Tawheed. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لا تشد الرحال إلا إلى ثلاث مساجد. You cannot travel unless if you go to any of these three masajid. You cannot go, I'm going to go specifically to so and so masjid. Unless if these are Al-Masjid Al-Haram in Mecca, or Al-Masjid Al-Nabawi in Medina, or Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa in Baytul Maqdis. But this is when Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa was free, not under occupation. Salah al-Din al-Ayyubi, rahmatullahi alayhi, he used to say, and he's from Kurdistan, you can just see how the Muslim Ummah, one nation, regardless to their race. And those one who always highlighted race and nationalism, and where are you from more than if you are Muslim or not, those people who are weakened the Muslim Ummah. Salah al-Din al-Ayyubi, he said, كيف آكل وكيف أنام وبيت المقدس في يد الصليبيين. How can I eat? How can I sleep? And Baytul Maqdis in the hands of the occupation, the oppressors. Salah al-Din al-Ayyubi, he used to say, إلهي قد انقطعت أسباب الأرضية ولم يبقى إلا الإخلاد إليك والاعتصام بحبلك والاعتصام على فضلك أنت حسبي ونعم الوكيل. هو الله. All the means in the earth stopped. And there is no one can bring Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa and Baytul Maqdis again except you. If we are coming back to your deen and we recognize your grace and your blessing, you are the most sufficient for us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easy for all of us to have the true understanding how we can bring Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa to be free as soon as possible. أقول ما تسمعون واستغفر الله لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله وبعد. الصلاة is فرض. Also الجهاد فرض. Also freeing all the occupied lands of the Muslims. بيت المقدس, كشمير and all other lands is the same. صلاح الدين الأيوبي spent 30 years in jihad, understanding Islam very well. Understanding that Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa has rights on us as Muslims. It is the first Qibla of Islam. In fact, the first 17 or 16 months of the history of Islam, people used to direct their prayer and face Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, Baytul Maqdis. And it is the land of Hashr, when Allah gathered all people for resurrection. And Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa comes after Al-Masjid Al-Haram with 40 years only, as the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned. To pray in Al-Masjid Al-Haram, Allah will reward you for each rak'ah 100,000, equivalent of the 100,000 rak'ah elsewhere. And Al-Masjid Al-Nabawi in Medina, 1,000, some narrations 500. And Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, as the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, four prayers in Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, they are equal to one prayer in Al-Masjid Al-Nabawi, meaning 25 prayers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة ولنجزينهم أجرهم بأحسن ما كانوا يعملون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we live based on Iman and a true understanding of Islam, Allah will give us very beautiful life. Life of Sa'ada, happiness of Iman, sweetness of Iman. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward us on the Day of Judgment with the best deed that we do. In fact, one standing, 1 hour for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to secure Muslim land better than the Qiyam of Laylatul Qadr. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam mentioned that a person who stands for his ummah doesn't know if he will come back to his family or not is much better at that night than the worship of Laylatul Qadr. And we are facing Ramadan soon. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless all of us with Ramadan. What we should do as Muslims? We should really bring the love of Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa to our hearts, talk about the journey of Isra and Mi'raj to our family, and bring the prayer as important part of our life. Manage our life based on prayer, not prayer based on our life. And we should stop complaining and showing our weaknesses. And we should strengthen ourselves and each other, because we have the Quran and we have the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we have great Muslim nation. But they just need leadership, and they need a true understanding of Islam, and they need pure aqidah and iman, so we can rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first and foremost, not on the material side of the world. We can support Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa maintenance and rebuilding, because there are lots of digging underneath it and tunnels, and almost the gate of Al-Maghariba now is destroyed completely, and all the surrounding area. We should support financially, we should make dua, we should support politically Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa and Bayt Al-Maqdis and people of Al-Bayt Al-Maqdis. And we should be careful when we donate and make sure that we donate to the right organizations. There are collaborators and there are people who betrayed their own nation and their own deen and their own people. Those people who have no faith at all. There are some families there, they have been there, are selling simple things. They are trying to survive, and they accepted to live simple life with that land because they understood the importance of the land and how holy this land and the blessing that Allah mentioned in the Quran. But what is expected is the support. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على الرسول المجتبى والنبي المصطفى وآل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين وزوجاته أمهات المؤمنين وصحابته القر الميامين وتابعين بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم، واغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولجميع المسلمين. اللهم اصلح بالنا وبال المسلمين يا حي يا قيوم، برحمتك نستغيث، أصلح لنا شأننا كله، ولا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين ولا أقل من ذلك. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد، والحمد لله رب العالمين.